So hello, this is the video for atmospheric chemistry portion of this course, Atmospheric Science and Air Quality, IEA501/3. And these are the topics for this atmospheric chemistry topic. There are five topics. The first is we're going to talk about the composition of tropospheric air, the sources and transport and sinks of air. Number three, we're going to talk about the tropospheric trace gases. And subtopic number four is about the tropospheric aerosol, and then topic number five on air pollution. These are the composition of tropospheric air, and then I've already discussed about this in a series of intro to atmospheric science playlist or list of videos for the first part of the course. Now, the most common unit for expressing the quantity of gas in the air is a fraction of the total volume of air that the gas occupies. So it's a fraction, that means it's dimensionless. And according to the ideal gas law, the volume at the same temperature pressure is proportional to the number of molecules. That means if you have more volume, then you have more number of molecules. And the partial pressure exerted by a gas in a mixture of gases is proportional to the mole fraction. So if we know the partial pressure, we know the mole fraction. If we know the equation that relates the two, and if we know the mole fraction, we know the partial pressure, which relates to the same thing as the volume and its proportionality to the number of molecules, because the more the mole fraction there is, the higher the mole fraction is, then the higher the partial pressure will be. So atmospheric gases, gases in the atmosphere can be considered as ideal gases. We can make that assumption. For example, carbon dioxide that occupies 0.04% of the volume of air, or more or less 400 ppm, means that the partial pressure of carbon dioxide in the air is about 0.04 fraction, or like I mentioned, 400 ppm out of 1 atm and 0.04 atm respectively. This is the composition of tropospheric air, a more detailed composition of tropospheric air in opposed to the more generic list that you saw in the earlier videos, in the earlier video. So the caption of this table is some gases in dry tropospheric air at a pressure of 1 atm. So nitrogen has the most, has the biggest presence in the atmosphere, and I think you know the chemical formula of nitrogen is just N2. And because it is the most abundant gas in the atmosphere, it occupies a larger fraction, a larger volume of the air at 78.084%. Now, the residence times of this nitrogen gas is very long. It's at 1.6 times 10 to the power of 7 years. Well, maybe because there's not a considerable sink that removes it from the atmosphere that causes the residence time to be large. And the major sources of where does this nitrogen gas come from, it mostly comes from biological sources. Same goes for oxygen at 20% or 21%. Still, the residence time of this gas is very long, from 3,000 to 4,000 years. And again, the source of this gas in the atmosphere is the biological source. Then it's followed by argon, the gas argon at about 1% of the atmosphere. And the source of this is, instead of biological, it's radiogenic sources. Then there's the carbon dioxide source, a very small amount in comparison to nitrogen, oxygen, and argon at 379 ppm, although right now it's about 400 ppm or so, or even more than that, maybe 440 or 430 ppm. But the residence time of this is by about 100 times lower than the residence time of nitrogen, oxygen, and The sources of this carbon dioxide gas is more varied. It comes from biological sources, oceanic sources, and also combustion. When we burn fossil fuel or when we burn organic material, the combustion process releases this carbon dioxide gas. Then there's the neon gas at a magnitude lower, at a 10 times magnitude lower than carbon dioxide at 18.18, and the source of this is volcanic, or there could be other sources that are unknown. Then helium, followed by methane, hydrogen, nitrous oxide, carbon monoxide, ozone. Notice that the concentration of these gases vary widely in terms of magnitude from nitrogen to the trace gases. This is followed by non-methane, halocarbons, hydrogen peroxide, and so on.